can never. All right, there we go. You got it. Hello, everyone. This is John Turnover, your host of Hidden Secrets, the show that's not afraid to push the envelope, investigating some of our most popular unsolved myths and mysteries. Now, if you recall in our last installment, we decided to take some suggestions about what should be our next case. And I am very proud to say that one of our newest subscribers, who goes by the handle Nightmare Slumber, actually had some great suggestions for us, asked us why do we spend so much time looking around at myths and urban legends that have been around forever. They're old, they're stale, we're not going to turn up anything new. And why don't we focus on something newer? So I thought to myself, you know what? That sounds like a great idea. Which brings us to our next case. None other than Jeff the Killer. Now, I have been doing my homework on this one for about a week or so. And I have to say, this one's pretty cool. I'm pretty into this. So I have here an article from an Oregon newspaper with some information about this. Check this out. Listen to this. So a chain of unsolved murders were piling up in a small no-name town in Oregon. That is, until a brave little boy was found as the only survivor of one of the last family murders. The little boy claims to have been awakened that night by a noise, rose from his bed, he notices his window is open, and that is when he sees it. A figure with two black eyes, bleached white skin, unrecognizable, and a smile that goes from one ear all the way to the other. And the figure leaned into the boy and said, "Go to sleep." And that is the summary of the first known encounter with Jeff the Killer. That is way cool. Now, since then, there have been all sorts of other sightings of Jeff the Killer across the state, which may or may not have anything to do with some of the other unsolved murders in Oregon, but that is not all. So, according to my research, this is the final picture of Jeff the Killer before he disappeared. Now, even I have to admit, I think this picture is maybe a little bit unrealistic, maybe a little Photoshop here and there, but it's going to be fun to look into this case and see if this is what Jeff looks like. So, hopefully, my crew and I are up to the challenge, and wish us luck. Stay tuned.
Are you out of your fucking mind?
No, I'm dead serious.
John, listen to me. We were all with you when you wanted to do your little paranormal investigation.
Yeah, and it turned out to be a great investment.
We lost half the footage, and I nearly got arrested.
That's right, Dan nearly got arrested.
Okay, look, first of all, I already told you, if you had been arrested, I would have bailed you out. And second of all, the footage was not lost. It was spiritually tampered with.
Oh, God, do not start on that bullshit again.
Look, guys, we have all read the research. You can't tell me you're not the slightest bit curious about what's going on here.
Well, it's not that we're not interested. It's just the article claims to be written in Oregon. That's nearly 5 hours from here.
See? Even Sandra, your own girlfriend, is having second thoughts about this whole Jeff thing.
Is that true, Sandra?
Well, let's be honest, John. Your last two projects haven't really taken us anywhere, and I think we're all a little tired of these ghost stories.
They're not ghost stories. They're unsolved mysteries.
Okay. That's it. I'm out. When you want to start making real movies again, give me a call.
Steven, come on. Hang on. Steven, wait.
What?
Look, I need your help on this one, man. My gut tells me this is the one.
But that's what you said last time.
Look. All right. I admit last time got a little bit out of hand, but not this time.
How do you know?
Because I have the address of where Jeff was last seen before he disappeared.
How did you...
It doesn't matter. All I need to know is, are you in or are you out? Look, everyone else will come along if you do, so that's what I need to know. In or out?
John, I don't even know what to say.
Well, it's a slate. It's not like you haven't done one before. Look, all right, just give us your name and your job title.
All right, I'm Sandra Bloom, and I'm one of the camera operators for John Turnover's latest documentary.
See? Is that so hard?
My name's Dan Silver. I'm the head camera operator.
Come on, man, you know I don't like being in front of the camera.
Name and job title, please.
My name's Steven Wisher, and I'm transportation. Can we go now?
You got your keys?
Yes, I've got my keys.
Well, all right, let's go then. So we're kind of not good at this whole woo thing, guys. Let's get jazzed up. Jazz
woo!
It up.
Yeah! Yeah!
Hello. Okay. He's alive? What's the deal?
No, he's not dead yet.
He's not dead yet, okay.
Not yet dead.
So he's a living, scary dude.
Sandra, what are you filming?
The highway.
Why?
Why not?
I'm going to find
what do you
clues.
Think? Clues? Mm. So we're gonna try to find where he is? Like, eventually?
But have you never watched Blue's Clues? What?
So you're telling me you actually believe we're gonna find a man with bleached white skin, dark circular eyes, and a smile carved into his face?
That's who we're looking for.
Can you believe this guy, Dan?
Right? It's like he's been watching way too many Christopher Nolan movies.
Watch it.
Is this the right place?
Yeah, this is where the directions take us.
John, I gotta say, it does not look all that menacing.
I never said it was gonna.
Let's just get this over with. It's already 2 in the morning.
Yeah, all right. Just, here, let me make a quick intro. On the outside, this may appear like any normal house, but on the inside lies the tale of Jeff, the killer. Tonight, my crew and I will enter this home to investigate the truth of what happened that grisly night. Prepare to have your nightmares revealed.
Yay.
Prepare to have nightmares revealed.
Really? Yeah. Come on. Haven't you ever heard of being in the moment? Because that's what I was just then. In the moment.
Okay. Fine.
Whatever. Pack it up. Let's go inside. Jesus.
Nightmares revealed.
I'm Judy, what do I keep you around for?
Give me a second.
Alright, be cool, guys. Be cool.
And there we go, ladies and gentlemen.
Genius.
John?
Yeah.
You wrote down the correct address, right?
Of course I did. Why?
Well, then why is there furniture in here?
Well, think about it. And Jeff murdered his entire family here, right? Kind of doubt people are going to want all the furniture.
I guess.
Okay, guys, here's the plan. The two of you are going to check out up here. Sandra and I are going to go downstairs and look.
Yeah, splitting up in a killer's house. It always works out in the movies.
Shut up, Steven.
All right, look, I'm the host, so if you find anything, you come find me. Got it? Sandra, let's go.
Oh, jeez. Keep an eye out for me, will you?
Where are you going?
I'm gonna take a shit.
You're gonna take a shit in an abandoned house?
It's not like anyone's gonna know. Look, we both know we're not gonna find anything. Just let John have his little adventure and we can go home.
Okay, yeah, but...
Yeah, I already talked to Sandra about it. After tonight, she's gonna talk to John and try and convince him that this hidden secrets crap isn't gonna take him anywhere. And speaking of crap...
Alright, I guess I'll let you know if I find anything.
Well, don't be surprised when you don't.
John, I can barely see you.
Yeah, I know. We'll get real flashlights next time.
Hold on. I think I might have found a light switch.
I don't think it's going to do you much good. Okay, that's funny.
Oh my god. John, I think we should leave. We're obviously in the wrong house.
No. This means something.
What are you talking about?
Don't you see? Jeff has somehow gotten power to this house without anybody knowing about it, which means...
John, cut the shit! What is it with you and your obsessions with these damn legends? They're nothing, just stories!
No, they are not just stories, Sandra.
John, We need to talk.
Oh, hey, Dan, what you doing this weekend, man? Are you gonna go to the bars trying to get laid? Nah, man. Go to Oregon. Go to some serial killer's house. Be huge. Big ass knife. What kind of food does a serial killer like? What the hell?
Okay, camera's off. It's just you and me talking here. John, babe, I need you to talk to me.
Do you think this is really the most appropriate time to talk about this?
John, you and I both know this conversation's been waiting to happen for quite some time. Look, I love you, but you need to face the facts. These documentaries aren't going to get us anywhere. Dan and Steve feel the same way. We're just tired of never finding anything. I guess I just need to hear it from you. Why are you so obsessed with these legends when everyone else has given up on them?
You just don't get it. You don't get it. I don't do this to be rich and famous. And there is a reason these stories have never left our collective consciousness. And I want to know why. I believe that if we find out the reason why, it will mean something. That is why I go after these.
Man, you're not going to believe it. There's still toilet paper here. Which is good, because I was about to... Dan? There's a camera on the floor. Dan? Are you fucking with me? Because it's not funny. Hey, did you open the shade? Someone's gonna see us.
John, maybe I overreacted. I know you're passionate about your work. It's just, the guys and I have been feeling lately that we haven't gotten anything from your projects. If you could maybe start considering our input more, then maybe I can convince them on continuing to help you.
No, you're right. You're right, I haven't. I haven't been considering you guys enough. If they're willing to stay, I'm willing to change.
Good. Come on, let's get out of here.
Yeah, I guess that's good for us. Jesus, what the hell was that?
Where's Dan and Steven?
I don't know, maybe they...
What is it? John?
Dan? Dan, is that you?
John, what are you doing? Be careful.
Oh, holy shit! We gotta go right now! Get to the car, get on the phone, call the police, I'm gonna find Dan! Oh, Jesus Christ!
Oh my God, we need to get out of here, we need to leave right now!
I fucking knew it!
No, John!
Whatever happens, keep recording, you understand me? Don't stop recording! Jeff! No one is gonna hurt you! We just wanna talk to you! Jeff?
John! John? John? Where are you, John? Jeff, if you're in here, I just want John back, okay? That's all I...
Sleep.
Ha 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 ha